Good evening and welcome everyone. I'm Cynthia Barber and I'm your Deputy City Manager and I'm so pleased to be here with you this evening and I'm extremely happy to see such a large and interested crowd in this project. Tonight's meeting is all about collaboration, so we're so happy that you're here. We're excited to hear your comments. We can provide those comments to us in several ways and I'll cover that in just a few minutes. Tonight you'll hear where we've been in this project. You'll also get an update as to where we are right now in the status of the project. And then we'll tell you what the next steps are and where we're going with the project. But most importantly, we'll get an opportunity to get your feedback so that we can incorporate it into this process. We're pleased that so many people are interested in envisioning what our community can have and what can be at the Northwood Centre site. This meeting will continue a lengthy process of us getting feedback that started about 4 years ago and started really out of an effort to find a new home for the Tallahassee Police Department. The Tallahassee Police Department right now is in a building that was not really built for that purpose, but served us well for many years. Since 1972, we've been in that building, and like any other building, you know, over time, the maintenance of the building, the adequacy of the building in terms of the size and the type of functionality that we need in a building, particularly when we're moving to and have moved to a community policing model, which forces a lot more collaboration and opportunity to interact with the public. The space that we have right now just isn't adequate for us. So we're looking to build a facility that will incorporate not only a housing for a location for the police department, but would be more inviting and inclusive for our community to have more positive and proactive engagement in our community. So we're really excited about that. And we'll address some of the constraints that we have right now, as I indicated before. This process of relocating the police department was a part of a strategic plan back in 2017. Where we actually, when developing a strategy on how we wanted to provide public safety services connected to the policing, the community policing model, and one of the main requirements of being successful is making sure you have a facility that supports the department's ability to implement those type strategies. Today you will hear from our project manager, Mr. John Powell, who's here with us. He'll talk to you about some of the where we are on the project, kind of where we've been, the technical pieces of the project. But we all want to talk to you a little bit about the engagement process. You might recall, and you may have actually been involved several years ago, when we were seeking to relocate the police department, we launched a very community-focused and engaged process where members of the community could identify locations where they would like to see the police department. We received tremendous feedback and we received information from several locations. The current site, the Northwood Mall site, was one that was of course, ended up being the selected site, but it was one of top three sites. And we heard not only where we'd like to see the police department, but there was a lot of interest about how we could deliver other services better in our community. And we ended up with one of the second locations, the Jackson Bluff site, being selected to build a fire station to address some of the coverage concerns that we had on the Lake Bradford corridor, but also an opportunity to implement or build a community hub, a city community hub on the Lake Bradford site. So we were very excited, again, to get that kind of feedback, and we're hoping that you're here tonight to provide a similar kind of feedback as we move forward in determining what will go on the North Monroe site. In addition to Mr. Powell being here, we also have Mr. Devin Levins, who will be giving an update basically on the process for the site and where we are in terms and how you can have feedback and what other kinds of amenities or buildings or businesses we might develop on that site as a part of the master planning process. If with that being said, I'd like to ask John, and then you'll also hear, I cannot forget Mr. Daryl Jones. Daryl was here, he is here. He helped help me get started this today, but Daryl will talk about some of the creative approaches we've been able to implement as a part of this project in employing community youth and some of the underserved community in this project. And we're really excited about it. It's a very innovative model that's been implemented working with our contractor on the project, Ajax. And so you'll hear about that. And so I'm excited to share that with you as well. And then most importantly, what we'll do is you'll have an opportunity to do the breakout sessions. You'll see that sections, you'll see that there are tables throughout the room. You have an opportunity to talk to those who are involved in the project, share your feedback directly, get questions answered, make suggestions, and you can either leave a card or written statement of what you'd like to see as a part of the project. You can share those comments verbally. I certainly would hope that you share them with us in writing. And then also this won't be your only opportunity, but you can also email feedback to us after you get the information that you need from those who are the staff and the team that are here tonight. John, with that being said, if you'll come up and give an update on the construction portion of the project.
Thank you, Ms. Barber. I'm John Powell. I'm the Director of the Environmental Services and Facilities Department. I'm also the project manager for the TPD headquarters site at Northwood. As Ms. Barber mentioned, after the City Commission selected the Northwood site back in January of 2020, we immediately launched into the pre-design phases of this project, which included updating that 2017 spatial needs assessment. We wanted to better determine exactly how much and what types of spaces TPD would need in order to meet both their current and their future projected law enforcement needs. It also included determining the best location for the police department headquarters within the overall Northwood site, which our technical experts tell us is generally within the northwest quadrant or corner of the property, which you'll see on the posters on the sides of the room and also in your handouts as well. So that particular area has a very steep land slope, if you're familiar with it. From the front near Martin Luther King all the way to the back of the property, it drops significantly, almost 40 feet. The good news is that the TPD building is really uniquely positioned to be able to kind of take advantage of that steep slope and use it to enhance security and storage and also for training. Also kind of pushing it back, and Devin will talk about this more, but pushing it back also maximizes the amount of future development area that's left over after the headquarters is built. So we're still on track to begin construction of the police department headquarters building in 2023, with completion near the end of 2024. But concurrent with that spatial needs assessment update that I just talked about, and most noticeably or visibly from the road, for example, we concurrently started working on demolition planning and permitting. The Northwood facility is a very large facility. It's over 500,000 square feet. It's a very old facility. It's over 50 years old. So not surprisingly, it presented a number of challenges when it comes to demolition. Again, not surprising for a facility of this size, type, and age. There were underground fuel storage tanks, which we successfully removed. There is also some residual contamination left over from the operation of a former dry cleaning business that was on the site. So the city and staff have been working very closely with the Florida Department of Environmental Protection to try to better understand the horizontal and the vertical extent of that subsurface residual contamination from the dry cleaner so that we can abate it, we can remediate it, and we can get regulatory site closure and move forward. There was also a significant amount of hazardous building materials contained inside the building, particularly asbestos throughout the building. Just for example, we safely removed 84 tons covering approximately 100,000 square feet of flooring that initially or originally used asbestos adhesive, which again, we had to properly remove with a licensed contractor and dispose of. And then as you would expect, there were other hazardous building materials within the building. There was lead-based paint, batteries, elevator, escalator, hydraulic fluid, HVAC refrigerant, all the kind of typical things you would see in a building of that size. And removal of those hazardous materials was important not only for worker safety, but we wanted to make sure that we separated the hazardous materials from the rest of the demolition debris so that we could maximize the amount of materials that we could reuse, repurpose, or recycle in accordance with the city's green building policy and our general overall aggressive sustainability goals. So demolition, even though it didn't look like a lot was going on at the time, was an inside-out process. Again, that internal hazardous materials abatement started back in March of 2021. 5 months later, we launched into the external demolition, which you can see from the road. To date, we have recycled more than 3,500 tons of metal and 10,000 tons of concrete. And we do expect to finish demolition with an 80 to 90% recycling rate, which is well above our initial goal of 75%. So despite these many challenges, as well as the construction labor shortage associated with COVID, the project moved very quickly, and in many ways it was ahead of schedule. As you have seen, if you've driven by the site, the entire Northwood main facility is now knocked down. Really, all that is left is a portion of the foundation and some small debris piles, which continue to be sorted. We do expect to complete demolition of the main facility in March, and followed immediately by site stabilization. And then we'll begin to do the same type of process with the two detached buildings to the south, which are border on Tharp Street. And by the way, before I forget, remember to visit the project website at talgov.com/Northwood Project so you can get frequent updates and also see some of the photos and the videos of our progress. So again, demolition of the size and scale doesn't occur every day in Tallahassee, and so while there were some challenges, there were also significant opportunities as well. And one of those, as Ms. Barber alluded to, were the various employment and training opportunities that the project provided. So to tell you more about this, about these innovative programs that the city has incorporated into this project, is Mr. Darrell Jones from the Tallahassee Leon County Office of Economic Vitality. Mr. Jones.
Hello, everyone. I'm Darrell Jones, and I'm delighted to be here representing the Office of Economic Vitality. I want to acknowledge my colleagues in place. I see Artie Shaw and the folks in planning. I also see present some folks who you know. You might not know their face, but if you've lived in Tallahassee any length of time, you've seen their work, and that is my friends from the Ajax Building Corporation. Jay Smith, come on up. Ted Parker, come on up. The reason I'm inviting them to join me, I'm delighted to tell you that at the direction of our assistant city manager and our city commission, this project, this landmark legacy project, has the potential to have enormous economic impact in our community because it will create jobs. Most specifically, working with Jay Smith, wave Jay Smith to the people, and Ted Parker, wave to the people, Ted Parker. We're working with them, we're going to guarantee that because our community has put an emphasis on economic inclusion, we're going to be able to guarantee, listen up, that 14% of this project will be devoted to both minorities and women-owned businesses, to the tune of 26%. Y'all applaud for that, because what that's going to mean is that this project is going to create jobs for both minorities in our community, but also there are a great number of women contractors. And also, what I think is also equally important, that devotion to making certain that everyone enjoys an opportunity to be employed on this project, that means that folks who ordinarily would not have this opportunity, it's made possible through our taxpayer dollars. This investment managed by Ajax Corporation to make certain that we have the greatest level of potential. Imagine this now. Oh, I gotta be at the microphone, I'm sorry.
But I won't talk as loud if I stand in the microphone, so let me bring it down just a little bit more. So let me help to translate what these guys are going to do and what this economic impact means.
So imagine if we're building the building, right? So we've got the design to do first. So that means that design is going to hire, they're going to have a contractor who's going to handle that, but then they're also going to have other persons, right, minority-owned firms and women-owned firms to help us to design it. Then when it comes time for us to build it, that means we're going to make certain that both minority-owned firms and women-owned firms are also going to have a chance. So now when you take that building apart, HVAC, that's a particular what we call specification. That specification will also have to meet the goal of 14% and 9%. Flooring will have to meet the goal of 14% and 9%. You see, we're doing the math here. What this means is that we're going to be able to generate a lot of jobs for a lot of our neighbors from across the expanse of the community. I want to acknowledge also Mr. Wayne Tanner, our assistant city manager in the back, and all of our members of the commission who have put a premium, our mayor and our commissioners have put a premium on what we define as economic inclusion. And I'm just happy that we have a partner with Ajax Building Corporation to make sure we get that done. Will y'all give them a round of applause? So thank you for coming to share, and we thank you for your interest in this great project. This project and its impact on our community will last for longer than a generation because of the jobs that it will create. So thank you for your interest, and thank you again for your support.
I'm Devin Levins. I'm with our Tallahassee-Leon County Planning Department, and I want to acknowledge Commissioner Jack Porter for joining us tonight. Commissioner. So what you guys have heard now is we know where the police station's going. That's kind of been set. But what we're looking for now is visioning what's left of the site. There's a lot to be looked at with what's left over on the site. And so some of the things that we know, the papers you have in your hand, you can see, we know we're going to have a north-south roadway that comes to the site and some east-west connections. Some of those are pretty logical based on current intersections or lights that are there. And that really gives you about 5 developable areas on the site that breaks it down really nicely to be able to start looking at what could go there. So what we're going to do for tonight is we're really going to start talking to you all and see what you want to see in those developable areas. So this is the time for us to really start looking at that so we can work with the consultants, Lewis and Whitlock, which are here tonight, ADG, which is here tonight, and being able to take what you all want to see and figure out how we incorporate that into the overall site plan. With that, Rodney Lewis with ALW, is there anything you want to add?
Thanks for everyone for being here. It's great to see everyone and looking forward to your involvement. The little louder. So folks from Architects Wilson Whitlock, Architects Design Group, and the Planning Department are manning our stations along the border edges of the room. So if you could raise your hand, you guys kind of look around. The idea here is we have a couple of large maps of the site in the middle of each side of the room. Those maps are laminated. There are pens over there. You can draw on the map. We can move building sizes, 9,000, 20,000 square feet, things of that nature. You can push them around on the table. It's an interactive process. There's a lot of folks here tonight, so be patient. Then we have idea boards on each side. So if you've got some great ideas, let's document them tonight. If you want to think about things a little further and what you've heard, then go digitally and add your ideas there, and we'll combine everything together. So looking forward to everyone's participation.
All right, and with that, we welcome everybody to come and see us at the stations, and we're happy to start talking to you and taking your ideas down. Thank you.
Thank you. All my life, I've been right here, right here. I'm tired of the traffic.
Well, that's just landscape. People who live right here, is that landscape buffer here?
It's the turn
between the
church
and the
woods
behind
that.
I think that might be
the post office.
Correct. The Wendy's is up here.
What else? What is Hudson wearing?
The empty? The folks that were here have relocated?
Well, I know that.
Great if there was some area here along. Yeah, that'd be
a green space where you might have either a food truck area, farmer's market, things of that nature.
Looking at the other stuff. I mean, access to technology is fine, but we have that at the libraries too. I don't know if it is needed. I guess it would just...